Hey guys, welcome back to My Colorful Country Life. Today I am diving into one of my new favorite techniques, basing with alcohol markers. I'll also be demonstrating this technique in a Frog's Tale by RJ Hampson using the promenade page here. So let's get started. Before we begin, let's talk a little bit about alcohol markers. So alcohol markers are perfect for creating a bold base layer on your colouring pages with their vibrant colours, their smooth application, which we can then enhance with coloured pencils on top or other media. They also dry really quickly and are less likely to leave streaks compared to a water-based marker. And there are so many different brands on the market. Because I am relatively new to this medium, I don't have a huge collection. So today I am going to be mixing different brands just to get the colours that I need for this page. And the markers I own are the 48 Honolulu set, which was sent to me from Ohuhu. And I have the 66 Artex Oros set, which I purchased because it is a set of pastels and I do tend to use a lot of the lighter pastel colours on my pages. And I have a bunch of the Spectrum Noir Tri-Blend markers, which I've been buying as singles. And these were the first alcohol markers that I actually purchased. So the Artex I find are quite a good dupe for the Ohuhu markers. And the markers I have in both these sets have both a brush tip and a chisel tip. And I'll just show you that in the Ohuhu as well. It's exactly the same, a brush tip and a chisel tip. Now, personally, I prefer a fine tip or a bullet tip over a chisel tip. That's just personal taste. And the Spectrum Noir, the tri-blends here do have a bullet tip. The chisel tip does come in handy for colouring large areas, but I don't tend to colour large areas like backgrounds with alcohol markers. I have done, but it's not something I tend to use them for. So a fine tip will be more useful for my style of colouring. Ohuhu also sells refills for some of their alcohol markers. And the Artex markers aren't refillable at this time. Now, the Spectrum Noir Tri-Blends, what attracted me most to these at first is that the marker is three shades of the same color. So this is the magenta blend, and you've got the light, the medium, and the dark. And I'll just grab a scrap paper and show you here. Let me move this out of the way so I don't get any bleed through. We've got dark, mid, oops, and light. So basically you get an inbuilt color combination in the one marker pen, and that is perfect for blending, and I will show you an example. So this is Rose and Her Friends by Evelyn Van Cotsen, and her hair was coloured using only one Spectrum Noir Tri-Blend marker, using the light, the medium, and the dark. So you can shade with your alcohol markers without using pencils or other mediums on top, which tends to give more of a painterly look. My style of colouring suits basing more, so that's what I'm going to be focusing on for today, but you can use just your markers without anything on top. So why do I base with alcohol markers? Great question. Well, there are a few really good reasons. Firstly, they allow for a quick and even coverage, which is fantastic when you want to lay down a large area of color on an element without spending hours. Second, alcohol markers provide a vibrant foundation. It makes your pencils pop when you add them on top and adds depth and richness to your artwork as well. And lastly, they make blending with pencils so much smoother, creating a seamless transition of colors. When you base with alcohol markers, the white of the paper gets completely covered, leaving no white space. The tooth is still there for laying your pencils down. It may flatten slightly depending on how many layers of marker you use, the pressure you use, and of course the paper you're working on matters as well. So it can make the surface of the paper less textured, but it also means there's no white space, it's less time blending, and you can get away with using less pencils to add in your shadows and highlights. Now, let me show you some examples of the vibrancy differences in books between pages where I've only used colored pencil and pages where I've used alcohol markers for basing. So let me have a look at this book. I think I've only colored the one. Okay, so this book, this page here was coloured with alcohol markers for basing and Prismacolor pencils on top. But if I show you Forest Song here, I have coloured a couple of pages in here with just Prismacolor pencils. So, I mean, I love the page too, and I love both these pages actually, but that one is alcohol marker basing with Prismas on top, and that is just Prismacolor pencils, and you can see that there is a little bit of white space popping through there. And that's another one which was just Prismacolor pencils as well, and you can see here, this is probably a good example, the squirrel here, the color combo looks very similar to what would be this color combo, but with the basing of the alcohol markers, you can see the difference in the depth of color and the vibrancy. So that's a really good example. What else can I show you? Okay, so back to Rose and her friends. We have, that's the one I just showed you there, which was based with alcohol markers. And Prismacolors on top of some elements, except the hair. And we've got like the King Art gel sticks in the background. But I do have another page, which is this one here, which is just Prismacolor pencils. So again, you can see the difference in the vibrancy. Both good pages, so you don't have to base with alcohol markers. It just depends on what kind of look you're after. So this was more of a softer page, so I wouldn't have based this one with alcohol markers. But this one, I want a bit more vibrancy, hence why I based it. And I'll just show you some other pages I've done with alcohol marker basing. Nightingales 3. This one here. Also, Prismacolors on top of the alcohol markers. For this one, I just used the pastel set, the Artex Oros? Is that how you pronounce it? The Artex set of 66 pastel colors. I will link it down below in case anyone's interested. So, we've got this nice sort of light but vibrant finish. And here is another page I've done based with alcohol markers and Prismacolor pencils on top as well. So I do have a tendency to use Prismacolors on top, but you can use polychromos or other pencils. It doesn't have to be Prismacolors, it's just I am a Prismacolor girly. So we've got that one. That is, I think that's one of my very first alcohol marker pages that I've done. Spectrum Noir Tri-Blends. And I think I used Prismacolor on top of that one too. And then there's that one there too. So, oh, before I forget, there is one more book I want to show you. This bad boy here is Wildergorn by Jamie Courtier. Absolutely amazing book, and it takes pretty much every single medium that you could possibly think of. Another book where I love to base with alcohol markers, and it's one of those books, one of those rare books where they don't bleed through. Now I've just got to find one of my completed pages here. Here's one. And not all of that is alcohol markers. Sorry, I'm trying to fit it in my desk without bumping the camera. So there is some intense basing as well. But I think, if I remember correctly, all the green grass is definitely alcohol marker basing. And like I said, this is a rare book where you get zero bleed through from alcohol markers. Okay. Now let's jump into our demonstration. So like I said, I'm going to be working in this adorable book by RJ Hampson, A Frog's Tale. And the picture that we're going to be colouring today is one I've been promising to colour with you guys for a long time now, and that is Promenade. Now, when working with alcohol markers, I like to work in single-sided books as the markers will bleed through to the back of the page, just like that. So you will get a shadow, a bleed through of your alcohol markers on the back of the page. Single-sided books. So a lot of the Amazon books are single-sided. You have Mel Pimenta's last two books, so Enchanted Earth and Nature Mandalas are single-sided. There are a couple of Kirbys, I think Phantomorphia and Geomorphia off the top of my head. Mythographic books are single-sided, so they're really good books to use your alcohol markers in. Because if you use them in a double-sided book, you are going to be sacrificing the page behind. So on that note, I do recommend placing a protective sheet underneath to prevent any bleed through onto the next page. I prefer to use plastic. Actually, the Ohuhu marker sets do come with a protective sheet. I just like to use one of my plastic binding covers here from my binding machine. So this is the perfect size, and I'll just pop it. That's a pretty page. Don't want to ruin that pretty page. So we just pop it behind like that, and I make sure it covers. I got my hair stuck under there too. Make sure it covers everywhere. If it is a little bit too small, you're going to have to move it around so you don't get any lines from your alcohol marker. So I like to start by choosing my colours. I like to pick shades that are slightly lighter than what I want the element to look like when finished. So choose a base colour which will be close in shade to your lightest colour, your highlight colour. Since we're going to be layering pencils on top to add depth and shading, you can lighten your base with a white pencil or a similar pale colour, or even by using the blender markers that come with some of your alcohol sets, as a blender marker is actually to remove colour from your page. So for our frog skin, I'm going to be using the Spectral Noir Tri-Blend marker in Alpine Green Blend, and I'm going to be using the light colour, which is a G1. And I'll zoom you guys in. So we're just going to work on her face for a moment. So what you want to do is apply your marker in light, even strokes. Try to color the entire element without stopping where possible so you don't get overlapping lines. Don't worry too much if you see some overlapping lines. We can smooth these out a little bit later with our pencils. So let's color her face. I'm going to color just the entire face here. Okay. Also, avoid using too much pressure to prevent the ink from saturating the paper. If you are blending your marker colors, do it while the ink is still wet for a smooth transition between the different colors. That is what it looks like from the back now. Another tip, try not to get too close to the lines, as it can feather out and bleed over the line. If your line work is quite thick, it's not too much of a problem. If you have thin line art, try to stay just inside it and it will feather out a little bit and cover that area anyway. Like I mentioned earlier, another great tool is a blending marker. It can help you soften any harsh lines by removing some of that color. Just remember to clean the tip after each use, just to avoid transferring colors the next time you use your blender marker. Once your base is dry, and with alcohol markers, it's almost immediate, we can start adding detail with our colored pencils. I'm going to be using my Prismacolor pencils today to add depth to our frog here. And I'm going to start with my darker colors and work from dark to light. You can work from light to dark. It's just personal preference. And in some areas, I might do light to dark. It just depends on what I want my end result to look like. If I don't know the depth of colour that I want on the element, I will usually start with lighter colours and build up to the darker colours. But if I already have a fair idea of what I want it to look like and how dark I want it, I will start with my darker colour. So you can do either way, it's no big deal. So for my frog skin, I'm going to be using Peacock Green, PC907, Grass Green, PC909, Apple Green, PC912, and Chartreuse, PC989. And chartreuse is quite similar to the colour that we put down. So that will just blend out the edges of my darker colours. As you can see, if I lift this closer, you can see there's no white spacer anymore. So I don't need to burnish the element as it's already been done with the alcohol markers. So now it's just all about adding in some shadow and some shading. The little spots on the frog, I think I might leave as is. And we'll just add some colour into her face. So I'm going to go in with peacock green first, and I'm going to start adding my shadows on the back of her head here. I'm also going to put some under her hat here, from the shade from her hat, and a little bit on the top of her neck here, coming from the shadow from her blouse, and maybe a little bit under her eye, just to make the eye pop out a little bit more. And I'm actually not using a hard pressure. I'm using sort of a light to medium pressure. I don't need to press too hard because it's already burnished. That part of the face would be in shadow. Bring it around the eye down here. And up on the neck. And I might also put a little bit down here on the side of her nose. And here too. Okay. Now I'm going to blend that out further. So over the top and extend with my grass green. And I'm also going to start to go over the eye a little bit. Now I'm going to go in and blend that out with a little bit of apple green. And again, just a medium pressure. I might actually put a little bit to add a bit of shadow to these spots. And last but not least, we're just going to blend out those edges with our chartreuse. And you don't have to cover the whole of the alcohol marker, just blend out the edges of the pencil work. So as you can see, the combination of alcohol markers and pencils really brings the frog to life. The markers give us that bold, vibrant base, and the pencils add the detail and depth. It's a fantastic technique. It speeds up your coloring process whilst also allowing for intricate details as well. So I'm now going to go and color the rest of this page. I will color it on screen with you all, and I'm just going to pop on some music for you, and I will be back at the end.
Thank you. 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 Thank you.
All right, guys, that is the extent of our alcohol marker basing. So what I'm going to do now is go in with the background and all my embellishments and finish off the page.
Thank you.
Okay, guys, that is our page complete. Thank you so much for joining me today. I hope you found this tutorial helpful and that you're inspired to try basing with alcohol markers on your own coloring books. If you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button. Happy coloring. Hope you have a wonderful day and bye for now.